Hi everyone, and welcome back. As you already know, we sell products every day at Stuffy Wood. Quotations, sales orders, and invoices are all part of our daily activities. Doing these by hand is annoying and time-consuming, so to fix that, we decided to use online quotations, which will save us a lot of time. With Odoo, we can create a quote, send it, and our customers will be able to sign and pay for it before getting their invoice in just seconds. How convenient. There's also a financial benefit since we can cross-sell by suggesting optional products directly on the online quotation. For example, if I sell a desk, we could then suggest another product to buy, like a chair. In one click, the customer can add it to the quote and pay for everything at once. More than increasing our revenue, using optional products will give more visibility to our other items as well. And for our workers, it's easier to manage because they only have to create the quotation and send it by email using an already made template. For example, we can create a template that will be used when a desk is sold, and based on how we build the template, we can give our customers the possibility to purchase complimentary items right then and there without manual intervention from our end. Doing this reduces tedious administrative tasks, and there will be fewer steps to go through and documents to handle. So let's see this in Stuffy Wood's database. All right, here I am on my database. So let's go ahead and jump to the sales application. Then we're going to go to configuration settings. From the settings page, I'm going to activate multiple options this time. So let's scroll down to the quotations and orders section. And here I'm going to activate online signature, online payment, quotation templates, and also quotation builder. Okay, and as you can see, I already have these four options activated. So let's go ahead and see how they work. All right, so the next step is to create a quotation template. Now I can get to that page by clicking on quotation templates right here, or I can go to configuration quotation templates. So let's create a new one. All right, as you can see, I have a couple already, but we're gonna create a brand new one right now by clicking on the create button. Now the first thing we're gonna need is a quotation template. So I'm gonna keep the name pretty simple. I don't want my salespeople searching through vague names to get to the correct template. So of course, this template will be for someone who wants to purchase a conference room table. So let me go ahead and add my product, which will be my large meeting table. Okay, I can add multiple products here if I would like to, but in this case, I'm just going to have the one product, all right? And I would also like to suggest that my customers purchase some additional items if they are purchasing the large meeting table. So to do that, I simply have to jump on over to the next tab, optional products, and I'm gonna add a couple of optional products as well. So of course, if they're purchasing a table, they might also need to purchase some chairs. Okay, but I have multiple kinds of chairs to offer, so I'm gonna give them some options. I'm gonna add my office chair, and my office chair black. Okay, so that way they aren't stuck with just one chair, but they can see all the products that I have to offer and choose between them. All right, so then we're gonna go over to the confirmation tab, and we're gonna be sure we have both online signature and online payment checked, which of course will allow our customers to sign and pay online. All right, so once I've done that, everything looks good so far. I do have a couple of additional options. Okay, so I have this field right here where I can say when the quotation will expire. So let's imagine on this template, I lower the unit price. Okay, but I only want this to be a temporary offer. I can say that this quotation will expire after a certain amount of days. Okay, and then on the right, I can also say that this quotation will only apply to a specific company. So I can say Stuffy Wood Belgium, for example, or I don't have to choose a specific company and say that this template can be used for all of my companies. All right, so let's save this. Now that we have saved this, we're gonna go ahead and design the template. So what our customers will see when they go to sign and pay online. So let's click on the design template button and we're gonna be redirected to our website. Okay, and then we can go ahead and quickly edit this page. So I'm going to click on the edit button and start adding some building blocks that we see on the left. Now I'm going to keep this pretty basic, but I do go over designing your web pages in more detail in the website videos, so be sure you check those out. Okay, so I'm going to simply drag and drop a cover. Okay, I'm going to add a catchy headline, which will say your conference room table, exclamation mark. That is pretty catchy. Okay, I want to be sure it's visible though, so we're going to change the size and the color. And then I'm going to say my products are so great. Yay. Okay, looks pretty good, but we're also going to change the background here to make it look even better. Okay, so I'm actually going to search for an image using Unsplash. And I'm simply going to search meeting. This image looks pretty good, so let's go ahead and add that. All right, so far so good. So let's save this design. And now that we have that web page design, we're actually going to go back to the sales application and create a quote using that template. Okay, so let's go to sales. I'm going to create a quotation. Okay, first of all, I want to choose my customer. And I don't have to add the products because all I have to do is select the template, and the products that are added to that template will automatically be added to this quotation. So as you can see, it's a huge time saver. All right, so let's go ahead and save this, and then we're going to send it by email to our customer, AC. Okay, I'm going to click on send. So, of course, my customer is going to receive it in their inbox, so let's go ahead and check that out. You see the status change from quotation to quotation sent right here. All right, here it is in my customer's inbox, which typically we won't have access to. And I'm gonna click on that email. I have the template, and then I can click on sign and pay quotation. When I click on this, it will redirect me to my website. Okay, and this will be that template design, or that web page that we just designed. All right, now I don't have to click on that link from the email in order to see this. I can preview the quotation as the customer from our side. Okay, so I'm looking at the quotation right now, and all I have to do is click on customer preview. And I'm going to see exactly the same thing that the customer will see. Of course, I'll be logged in. So since I clicked on this link from the email while I was logged in as the administrator into this database, I did see it while I was logged in. Of course, if I have this same link and I'm not logged in, I just simply will not be logged into the website. Okay, so I just won't be able to go to the dashboard and edit, but this entire page will be exactly the same otherwise. All right, so if I scroll down, I'm gonna see the product that the customer would like to purchase. I have the quotation for that, tax included, subtotal, and everything. But right below that, I'm going to see those optional products that we added to the template. And then the customer is going to be able to add those optional products directly to the quote right away. So they don't have to call us and say, actually, your office chair looks pretty good. I would like to buy 4. They can do it immediately. And all they have to do is click add to cart. Okay, and then of course the page will load, and once it's done loading, the item will be added to the cart, and they can specify the amount that they would like to purchase as well. All right, and that's taken into account in the total, and also taxes are applied as well. Okay, so once I've done that, then I can go ahead, I see that the total has changed here, and then I can go ahead and sign and pay. Okay, so let's go ahead and use auto, accept and sign, and we see that I'm accepting on the behalf of AC. And once I've done that, I'll be able to pay. Okay, pay and confirm. So right now I only have the wire transfer option, and then I can pay and confirm online. As you can see, it has barely taken any time to be able to add those optional products, sign the quotation and confirm it, and already pay for the sales order. Okay, so I can take care of everything right away. All right, so as you can see, the flow is super simple. Now, if we go back to the quotation from our end, okay, we're gonna see that the quotation is waiting for a wire transfer payment. Okay, so the customer was able to do everything, and we just simply have to wait. We send the quotation and we let the customer take care of everything else themselves. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.